Guys, today is our topic about the hemostasis. Hemo mean blood and stasis mean stopping. This process is causing of the blood stopping. Hemo, blood. Stasis mean so for this process we should know about the normal blood flow in the vessel. We know that the normal blood flow of the vessel is the laminar flow. If we come to the, here's the blood vessel, and the laminar flow of the blood vessel is laminar flow. These are the endothelial cells in the vessels, and these cells release some chemicals. These chemicals maintain the normal flow of the blood. What's name of these chemicals? These chemicals are PgI2, nitric oxide, plasminogen activator, these plasminogen activator active the plasmin. Plasmin actually cause the fibrinolysis and heparin like sulfate. Heparin sulfate active the antithrombin 3. Which active? Antithrombin 3. And next one is thrombomodulin. Thrombomodulin active the protein C. Thrombomodulin. These are the chemicals which release from the endothelial membrane, and these chemicals maintain the normal flow of the blood. And if there's injury occurs into the blood vessels, there's a presence of the endothelial membrane, then these all chemical will not release. And when these chemical will not release, then here present of the blood cells, we know that red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, the platelets will come toward the endothelial membrane, and they bind with the endothelial membranes, with the endothelial cells. This process, when bind the platelets with the endothelial membrane, this called the adhesion. And when the injury occurs, then the blood will come outside from the vessels. But first step in the hemostasis is the vasoconstriction. We know that why the vasoconstriction occur. The vasoconstriction actually occur due to the one reason, because it inhibit or escape or reduce the blood flow from the vessel. For example, if the vasoconstriction will not occur, then the maximum blood will come out. But if the vasoconstriction occur, then the vessel reduce the blood coming from outside from the vessel, which cause to the vasoconstriction. When any injury occurs into the blood vessels or the any site of our body, then there is a present of the specific receptors, pain receptors. These pain receptors cause to the vasoconstriction. And there is also present, we know that when the injury occurs, then the process of the inflammation also happen. And the inflammatory process also cause to the vasoconstriction. When injury occur here, smooth muscles are also present here, and the myogenic process also cause to the vasoconstriction. Mean that there are the three mechanism or the three process or the three factors which cause to the vasoconstriction. First one is the second one is inflammatory. And myogenic. Here's when the endothelial membrane will be damaged, then from the endothelial pallid cells secrete of the von Willebrand factors. Von Willebrand factor bind with the von Willebrand factor, these von Willebrand factor bind first to the platelet. When von Willebrand factor bind with the platelet, this von Willebrand factor bind with the platelet and there's need of a protein which name is a GP1B. GP1B. If there is a deficiency of the GP1B, then von Willebrand factor can't bind or adhesion occur with the platelets. And we know, for example, when injury occurs, then the platelet when bind to the von Willebrand factor, the platelet also stimulate and secrete some chemicals. And these chemicals name is the ADP and thromboxane A2. These chemicals, ADP and thromboxane A2, these chemicals stimulate the other platelets that come to and bind with the injured site of the endothelial membrane. When these stimulate, when these platelets will come and bind with the injured site of endothelial membrane, then it, this process is called to the aggregation when they are coming. When a platelet bind with another platelet, then there is also need a protein which name is GP2B3A. GP2B3A. Here's protein name is the GP2B3A. This protein cause to the platelets to platelets adhesion. And when more platelets come to the injured sites, then there's form of the plug. This formation of the plug occur at the site of the injured blood vessels. Then the another mechanism start, which is known as this platelet is a plug formation is a weak. And for the femme platelet or the thrombus, there's need of the cascade of the clotting factor mechanism. There's happens and activate of the clotting factors. So here's a quick review. Hemostasis, hemo mean blood, and the stasis means stopping. This process is cause of the stopping of the blood. The chemical release from the endothelial membrane which cause to the laminar flow, these chemicals name are the TGI2, nitric oxide, plasminogen activator which active the plasmin and cause the fibrinolysis. Heparin sulfate active the antithrombin 3, thrombomodulin active the protein C, and these active the platelet factors of the 5 and 8. If there's injury into the endothelial membrane, then von Willebrand factor release and bind first of all with the platelets. And von Willebrand factor when bind to the platelet, there's need of the protein which name is the GP1B protein. And there's also release from the platelet factors which stimulate the other chemicals platelets to come to the injured site of the endothelial membrane. These chemical name are the ADP and the thromboxane A2. When these platelets will come and bind to the another platelet, there is also need of another protein which name is the GP2B3A. And when these all platelets will combine to each other and form a plug, this process is caused a plug formation, and this plug is a weak. And for the theme of this plug or the thrombus, we will discuss